This entry of All Hyped Up is going to be about Ratchet and Clank Future, A Crack in Time, which was originally going to be titled, and you know, this was kind of funny, Clock Blocker. But, you know, I guess they just decided to go more, a little more kid friendly or family friendly title as Crack in Time. Anyway, this is going to be a PS3 exclusive that's going to be released on October 27, 2009. And there's probably a lot of good reasons to be hyped up about this. The first reason is that it's going to be the, you know, as a sequel, it was needed, because Ratchet and Clank Future Tools of Destruction, the prequel, ended in a bad cliffhanger. Like, the ending of that game was so abrupt, like, it was just like, boom, Clank is now separated from Ratchet. What happens next? That's the ending of the game. And so, you know, this continuation of the story was really necessary, a must. And so I'm really hyped to see how the story plans out. And looking from the trailers too, it looks like it's much more fleshed out story this time. You know, the prequel focused a lot on the past of Ratchet and the Lombex history. But although it didn't really reveal too much, it was still really interesting to see the series take a more serious tone with the storyline, even though it had bunch of comedy and humor, but it just didn't feel like a random entry like the three PlayStation 2 Ratchet games did. So this game is going to have more of that, where now we see for the first time another Lombax other than Ratchet, and he seems to know a bit about Ratchet's father. But beyond that, this is actually more a story about Clank. I think for the first time in a Ratchet and Clank game, Clank really gets the spotlight. And, you know, I know there was a PSP title, Secret Agent Clank, but that's more of a spin-off title. This is actually, like, Clank's actual history. We get to see, you know, his birthplace, maybe his father, or, you know, some kind of story relating to that, and how the Zonies, these little crazy creatures with time-bending powers, how they relate to this whole saga. So I think, story-wise, this is a really cool way. I know the story hasn't been the coolest thing about Ratchet and Clank Future, because it's really just basic kid-friendly stuff, but it's still promising to be really humorous, really funny, and the epic tale behind Ratchet and Clank, I think that's going to be the most interesting thing. There's also a lot of differences here. With Clank as the focus, this Ratchet and Clank game will be the game with the most Clank gameplay ever. There's actually going to be boss fight with Clank. Not only that, following the title of the game, you know, a Crack in Time, is really going to have time bending mechanics set for Clank. So when you're a Clank, you're able to record and stop the footage of Clank's movements and have up to four copies of that to solve puzzles, which is really interesting. I know this is kind of making you replay certain sections, because, and that might get repetitive, but it is a really cool concept of seeing, you know, your recorded footage of yourself becoming actually doing those actions. So record a Clank standing on this button to open the door, and then your actual self goes through that door. So there's a little puzzle element there, and you can throw time bombs and whatnot to fight bosses, and, you know, using time structure for combat and puzzles as Clank. So this is new for the series. Another new thing for the entire series as a whole, and this hasn't been done for a franchise, I don't know why, but it took them this long, but it's the space combat and exploration is you now get to explore. So there is, you know, when you're jumping from a planet to planet, you don't just jump to another planet, and you don't get the controlled segments that the previous Ratchet game, some of the previous Ratchet games had, but you actually get to control your spaceship. The control is limited. There is no, like, 360-degree control, and you don't go up and down, because they still want to, you know, direct the experience and make it engageable enough, but feel free enough. So you'll be shooting stuff down, you'll be collecting stuff, and there'll also be secret planets to explore, and these secret planets will be two kinds, you know. They're offer two different kind of challenges. One where you'll have to wipe out, it's like an arena challenge in previous Ratchet games, where you have to wipe out all the enemy in a given time without dying. And also another one where there's a platforming challenge, where you have to get to this point B starting from point A, but the platforming will be very challenging. There'll be planet with, that's just a lava-filled planet, you know, acid-filled planet. So there's different kinds of things, and the more zonies you collect, the more upgrades you have. So there's 40 zonies to collect, so there's a lot of secret unlockables in this game. So this exploratory nature opens that game up to being, you know, replayable and being able to find all these secret side missions. Ratchet and Clank really didn't have that much side missions, so I guess A Crack in Time is trying to fix all that by having so many more side missions, so many more exploratory nature, more collectible stuff. So that's the really cool aspect of this game. And of course, the one thing that is always the most thing to be hyped about in Ratchet and Clank title are the weapons. This time around, like, there's gonna be some returning weapons. I'm not too sure what, but I'm pretty sure it's like the tornado launcher and whatnot from the Tools of Destruction. But the new weapons are pretty cool. There's a burp gun where you shoot out burps. But the one unique feature about this Crack in Time is that, I don't know if they did it for other games, but for Crack in Time, they did a contest where users like us submitted, you know, their weapon design, and they got picked. And so one of the weapons got picked. I think it's called like Spiral of Death, and it shoots out these glowing saw blades that return to you after being a certain distance. But, you know, it's going to be pretty much an awesome Ratchet and Clank title with these kind of new features. And another new feature that I haven't mentioned is being able to customize the appearances of weapons and whatnot. So that is really cool, because Ratchet and Clank is really a game more than just about platforming and action. It's really about the weapons themselves, and the weapons are going to be really cool in this game, I hope. So, you know, it's going to be a really great PS3 title. I don't know how improved the graphics are going to be, but even if they didn't really improve that much on Tools of Destruction, it's still really colorful and still looks really brilliant, so I'm not too worried there. Overall, I think this is one PS3 game that really needs to be, you know, hyped up more. I feel like it's kind of under the radar at this point, but I feel that it shouldn't be. So, you know, I'm really all hyped up about this, and I hope it turns out to be another great Insomnia title.